What's up, Cameron? Man, I told you we'd do this for you, man. You know, I was thinking about you. You know, you had asked about the other people and Daryl and other people that were there that you knew. This is Jeremy, by the way. Jeremy, I told you about him before. And he's good at this shit. He's the best out of all of us. So he's going to be doing the talking here. I'm going to ask questions. So,
well, immediately when Matt said about this young boy, I said untimely death, and I said that he drowned. I didn't know he drowned, you know. I mean, I felt that, you know, that he immediately drowned. He fought to, you know, not drown, you know. I could see that, you know. It was a struggle with the waves, you know. Possibly a rock hit him, you know. Go ahead.
You know, but, see, he didn't know that. I hadn't told him, you know. I just mentioned it. I was like, well, you know, that's what he saw pop up in his mind before I even mentioned it.
I've done another reading where somebody had drowned, and it just immediately struck me the same way, you know, the drowning situation. I don't know how to say that, the bubbles and things, but...
But listen, Daryl, man, were y'all and Cameron close or something like that? Are you good friends or something like that?
Yeah, it was, yeah. You know, at the time, you know, there was a lot between them, you know. As friends, you know, but it was cut short, you know what I mean? Cut short with a lot of questions to be asked and a lot of things unanswered. It was rough for anyone that was young to know him and then have that happen.
So this isn't going to be, this really is going to be more, I think this is, could be, I could see how this could be more than just Cameron with this. I mean, it's like he feels, he wants to reach out because of the unanswered questions.
There's
and
a lot of people, yeah.
He wants to reach out to more people, this
right.
Daryl does.
Right.
We can do that, man.
Yeah, there was, you know, a lot of unanswered things, but it wasn't like his death was horrible to himself, you know, as much as it was to people around him. He passed on quickly. You know, like I said, there may have been a rock that, you know, knocked him unconscious, but he's saying, what's up? You know, hey, what's up? Yeah. What's up, guys? What's up, homeboys? Yeah, homeboys. That's the word he used maybe at the time.
Homeboys.
Homies.
You know, homies, yeah.
that whole genre saying, hey, you know.
Go ahead with it, Daryl, man. Say what's on your mind, my brother. You know?
Well, he misses his mom. He misses his mom. He misses his dad. This is the first thing. He misses the friends that he had. You know, that is almost like a rhyme, you know. But don't worry. He's okay. He's happy. You know, he's playing with his dog. You know, he has a dog, black dog. Black dog is with him. You know, that was his dog. That was his dog. He's wearing a cap on his head, kind of funnily, kind of loose, you know, tan t-shirt, something logo on it, you know, jeans and tennis shoes.
Oh yeah. Mm-hmm.
But he has light skin, you know, his eyebrows are kind of fluffy, you know. I'll explain that. I don't know, you probably know what I mean more than by that than what I do.
Kind of like pussy eyebrows or just thick, maybe?
Thick. Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe a scar or something, you know. This is what I'm seeing. Something to do with this part of his head, you know. They probably know more than what I'm talking about, you know.
This is a message for them, not for us, you know.
Yeah.
You know, he's trying to reach out, so... I mean, and on the animal thing, I want to say something about that. Like, we've seen them come through. Like, I've seen, like, a guy named Simi comes around me with this white cat, you know, all the time, this particular spirit, you know. Now, you know, he has a dog, you know.
Yeah.
You know, because animals live on just as much as humans do, or, you know, anything else. I mean, everybody, just no one dies ever, so nothing dies, you know.
But he has a big smile on his face, and he's saying, what's up, what's up? Like, he almost feels like he's on screen.
You know? You are on screen, yeah.
He's like, you know, look at me, you know, I'm all right, you know. This is a lot of energy and ecstaticness, you know. You probably remember that from him being a young guy. He had energy, he has energy, lots of it.
Lots of energy.